Autumn helicopter, but not. Rotor on the top, totally unpowered. It becomes, if you like, a spinning disc, a spinning wing. The power is behind in a small piston engine. And Peter presents a very, very good display in this exceptionally high-tech machine. Rotor starting to spin up, it has the ability to start spinning. Then from there on in, it's the motive power of the aeroplane that keeps that rotor going. Very high-tech aeroplane. And just like modern motor cars these days, full caliber.
So folks, Peter assures me he's vaping. You can see he's very manoeuvrable. Again, keep an eye on him, just in that fishbowl-like cockpit, you can see you all the time. And sideways is no problem for Peter. The engine, which is a 100 horsepower Rotax, propels him around at a maximum of 114 miles per hour. Carbon fibre makes up some of the components in this aeroplane. If you like, it's a sort of motor car, a scooter of the air. Sean Connery battered and battled with the evil people in Japan. It's not a general comment, by the way, that's specific about the plot of the film. Peter has over 2,000 flying hours to his credit, and they vary from hang gliders to a Wessex helicopter, to an Antonov AN-2 massive biplane. What a gentleman he is as he bows to you, give him a wave. What a takes over.
They're probably based on...
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if you cast your eyes out to the left, please confuse me, it's Nigel Wilson running in the Holy King Yak 52. The Yak 52 is a Russian military trainer. These aircraft first flew in the 1970s, and they can be seen at the aerobatic competitions over in the west.